Hey, it's Alpha Bob. Back with another trip into high security space for some more hacking. But this time I will not cherry-pick the sites. I've had many subscribers upset that I leave containers unhacked. I have done some self-reflection on this. And I do agree that in high security, I should not cherry-pick. It doesn't take much time to explode the worthless containers, and since there are many new players trying to hack in high, it leaves them with a bad experience to find unfinished sites. But in wormholes and null space, I still think cherry picking helps you make more ISK and it decreases the time you could be attacked by a hunter. To make amends, I've recorded this hacking session of no cherry picking any of the data or relic sites. This video showcases an unedited 45-minute session featuring my journey back to Jita and the subsequent sale of my loot. It serves as an excellent illustration of the accomplishments a new alpha player can attain while ensuring 100% safety. Skip ahead to watch the 5 data sites and 1 relic site I find to hack. I also come across a superior sleeper cache site, but I don't have enough probe scan strength to scan it down. These sites can be safe to run and can pay out 100 million ISK. The last site I scan is a covert research site. This is also known as a ghost site and is very deadly. I fly into the site to show what the loot looks like, and I hang around long enough to see the rats arrive to blow up the site. Stick around and watch what you might expect when you are hacking in high security space. This is perfect for a new player to improve their confidence with scanning and hacking relic and data sites. You can skip ahead or watch the entire video. This is a very typical run, making about 10 million ISK per hour. Not a huge amount, but enough to get your feet wet and eventually build up to exploring null and wormhole space. You can also stay in high, eventually upgrading your ship to an Astero. Exploration is a great way to have fun and Eve, and can make enough ISK to help plex your account. Or you can stay an alpha player and still enjoy the excitement of flying through null space, making lots of ISK and dodging all potential hunters. Stick around and watch what you might expect when you are hacking in high security space. This is perfect for a new player to improve their confidence with scanning and hacking relic and data sites. You can skip ahead or watch the entire video. I'm using the agency window to find the nearby systems with multiple signatures to create a route of jumps. Make sure you use the optimize route button to shorten the total number of jumps. Then it's just a matter of scanning for relic and data sites. I'll comment a little bit more for each of my stops, but for now, sit back and enjoy the show.
Warp drive active. Active. Backup drive active.
This first data site isn't worth much, but I will hack two containers here. Like I said, no cherry picking for me.
Warp drive active. Warp drive active. drive active.
Here we find a relic site. Usually relic sites are better than data sites, but in high security, I find data sites a little bit better. You will see me explode the worthless containers by failing the hack twice. This takes a few extra seconds, but this is what's required to make the site despawn.
Drive active. Thank you. Active.
We find another data site, nothing too special.
Warp drive active. Active.
Yet another data site. I will explode more cans, but if you are new to hacking, take this time to practice playing the hacking minigame.
Warp drive active.
This site is hard to scan. It's a level 5 data site. This will be a superior sleeper cache site, which can be worth over 100 million ISK. But I only have 74 points of scan strength on this Heron fit. As an alpha player, you can achieve over 105 points of strength with an Astero ship. This is a great explorer ship, but will cost over 100 million ISK.
Warp drive active. Drive active.
This data site is worth 5 million ISK.
Warp drive active. Thank you. Warp drive active. Drive active.
This last data site is a Lesser Gurista's covert research facility, commonly known as a ghost site. This by far is the most dangerous thing to any new player in high security. Until you are ready, don't attempt to hack any of the containers at this site. To show you what it looks like, I will walk to the site. Notice this warning.
Active.
This is your sign to warp off once you land. But I will stick around until the rats arrive.
Thank you.
I will cargo scan all the containers to see what type of loot is possible. But be warned, once you start a hack, you must complete it successfully. One failed attempt and it will explode for 8,000 damage, killing you instantly. And to make this site even more deadly, there are a bunch of rats that will warp into the site and very quickly warp scramble your ship, shoot you, and then shoot the containers. You will only have a few seconds to warp off. And if you warp away while hacking a container, that container will instantly explode and destroy your ship in the process. Ghost sites can be fun and profitable to run. You can use a cheap heron fit to quickly hack one or two cans and then warp away. But be ready, you will lose a ship from time to time. There are other fits I'm testing out for a better chance to survive, but that's for another video. Here are the rats. They can appear from anywhere between 30 seconds to 2 minutes. Once they are on grid with you, they will attempt to lock your ship with a warp scrambler after about 10 seconds, but I'm too far away for them to catch me. They will destroy any remaining containers and will warp off.
Warp drive active. 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 Autopilot engaged. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted. Autopilot disabled. Waypoint reached.
Here I am back in Jita. Ready to sell my loot for just over 7 million ISK. Like I said, not a huge amount, but this was completely safe to run and is a good start for the newer alpha players out there. Thanks for watching, subscribe if you haven't, and happy hacking.